Hi, this is Dr. Rashmi Shetty. I'm a practicing endodontist and aesthetic dentist at Chisel Dental Clinic, Koramangala, Bengaluru. Along the journey of science, few treatments come along that actually change the way science practices. And in dentistry, laser is one of them. So it is not just a fad that has come in. And the most commonly asked question nowadays is, laser for everything, is it really required? Laser is here definitely to stay, as it has made life easy for the dentist as well as for the treating patient, where it ensures predictable healing and non-discriminatory removal of bacteria, unlike even your antibiotics. Now, where can laser be used? It can be used for a simple laser bacterial reduction, which commonly is heard of nowadays as laser cleaning. And what does it do? Along with your regular cleaning, when the laser light is used, it removes the bacteria like how the cleaning removes the house of the bacteria. Okay, whenever you do a cleaning, what we do, we take out all the deposit or tar that is formed, which is basically the house where the bacteria rests. And now the bacteria that is free flowing, when laser is used, brings down their count as well, and it takes a lot of time for that bacteria to multiply again. Now this is the basic rationale of using laser. But where else do we use? It has made gum treatments more predictable in terms of gum surgeries, and they are non-invasive with faster healing times. So we do use them in laser surgeries with a more technical term called as LANAP, which is nothing but laser assisted new attachment procedure, where the gums attach back to your tooth. Now they are also used in multiple small ways to make life easy. That is in terms of just enhancing your smile by bringing back the pink quality of your gums, or in slight crown lengthening procedures, especially post braces, to kind of contour your gums to give an aesthetic smile. They're also used to relieve pain, especially when there is excessive pain immediately post a root canal. They can be used. They're used to disinfect your root canals as well. They're also used in ulcers nowadays, where post laser exposure, the pain immediately comes down. Immediately post laser treatment, there is bound to be slight discomfort, which usually a painkiller takes care of. But despite that, if there is more discomfort, you can always get back in touch with the dentist, but they are much more easier to handle than a gum surgical procedure. Now that slight discomfort can be avoided by placing an anesthetic gel on top, and healing can be promoted by using vitamin E capsules or their gel form. Diet has to be maintained in that we cannot have anything hot, spicy, hard immediately post any laser treatment. Give the gums time to settle down and heal. We can use a mouth rinse also, preferably post 48 hours. So the first 48 hours, you'll just be using a gauze piece to slightly cleanse your gums in the area where it has been worked upon. To eat, you can always have curd rice or something really soft for the first 1 or 2 days, and avoid anything hot or spicy. Drink lots of fluids, that is at least about 1.5 to 2 liters of water every day for the next 2 to 3 days, as you need to rehydrate your body back. And after 7 days or even 14 days, even if you're feeling fine, just come and show once. But in these 7 days, what you will see is a whitish layer forming on the gums, which kind of makes patients anxious if everything is healing fine, but that is quite common. It looks like pus, but it's just a slough layer that is forming, which slowly gives way to pink and red spots. And it's only after about 5-6 days or 7 days that you see the color of your gums returning back. So there's usually nothing else much to worry about when we do a laser treatment. You slowly ease your gums back into function. When you can start brushing regularly using a brush is only post your checkup, that is 2 weeks down the line. And until then, continue to use a mouth rinse, use an antibiotic gel as well as a painkiller gel if they are prescribed, and your vitamin E gel to ensure that healing is good. If you feel there is any delayed healing, definitely get back in touch with your dentist immediately so that the things don't go worse. And also, if required, they may put you on multivitamins to ensure complete healing.